NerdDice.
Welcome to the Stateless Codecast. This is episode number 70 in our series, Create a RubyGem, NerdDice. So in this episode, so reviewing what we've done previously, back in episode 66, if you haven't watched it yet, go back and review that. We went over how dynamic methods with method missing in Ruby work. And then in episodes 67 through 69, we went through and wrote some specs, wrote some of our simpler use cases. In this episode, we're going to try to allow for the addition or subtraction of a bonus as part of the method name. So that's what we're going to take a look at here. If we go to our examples of bonuses, so things like this, roll d20 plus 6, roll 3d8 p2, roll total d20 minus 5, roll 3d8 minus 3. So kind of those ideas are what we want to implement in this episode. So we'll get rid of some of our tabs here, and similar to what we did in the last episode, we will start with our by copying our role spec here, and it will be start with plus n and see if we can get that working. So we've got our items here. So still going to call that, but we're going to we'll just deal with the method options, and then we'll have another one called merged options. Six here. So in all of our cases, we're going to wind up calling roll dice with merged options rather than method options. That one different. So for all the other ones, we will be doing +6. So we'll see if we can run that. Imagine all of them will fail. Do, which is expected. So now let's see if we can go in and implement this so that it works. So we'll go in more specifically, and have so that's kind of the idea that we'll have here. And we will add this down below. This is going to be very similar to what we get here, except for we'll have to have from method name. And then we will so there are some considerations here. We'll see how much of this works first, and then we'll add in those additional considerations. So we've got that item, and then our similar to what we did before. Actually going to want get, yeah, we'll call it get bonus. And it's going to be, we're matching on there. Let's take this into the console. sure I'm doing it correctly. Method name is not. So we'll get an example here. If I can chain this. So that seems to have worked. Back to convenience methods. Zero or one of this LUS. Let's go back over to trusty old Rubular. Yes, that should. Yep, that still works. So we will try that. And then we're going to, now we'll get into that situation where we've got a problem with the bonus. So that's how we'll do it. So if and so we're going to check if there are keyword arguments and there is a bonus, and furnace does not equal our bonus. We will look at how we have raised errors in the past. So NerdDice on namespace error. We'll deal with that later. And then otherwise, let me make sure that we merge it properly. So that will return the combined hash, which is what we want. Okay, so we need to test for this situation. Let's go back to our spec here. Raises error bonuses inconsistent with keyword arguments. Expect this would be a NerdDice error. Let's see where we stand in terms of our specs. All right, so we've got 7 failures now. That's okay. So some of that is failing because it needs to be. So here, this needs to be two S, two I. All right, we still have 6 failures, so let's take a look at. Failing at here. So we have not changed our... Okay, we're not adding the bonus in yet, so that's... Check bonus integrity. So that still needs to work. It's not defining our method. Because let's see here, method name args splat args block. Not using the block. Sides, number of dice, bonus, keyword arguments, and then size. Number of dice, double splat, keyword args. All right, let's at least see if we're hitting that method. We are hitting that method. We are raising the error, which is good. So bonus 6. So let's see if just see if that changes anything. Still not giving us our bonus. Maybe integrity here, see if it's providing something odd. We'll just isolate to one example so that it's easier to read. We'll go with 20. Okay, so it's in there, bonus integrity. It's giving this value. Let's find out what bonus is here. Just need to a hash. Or do I? So let's go back to our console here. So that's returning a hash. Maybe if I just go the other way here, try not to be too fancy. As our bonus here. Did we get anything about the bonus? Bonus integrity. Yeah, it is giving us the bonus. Turn keyword arguments, see if that okay. It is still not defining here. Let me go back to convenience methods. See if we can isolate this bug here. So, got that. We're getting sides, we're getting dice, we're getting the bonus. Merge arguments are working there. There's an underscore. All right. So we've got our keyword arguments. Double splatting there, which is fine. And then use the underscore. That fixes things. It does not. All right, let's see what else we're doing that's different. Method name, method name, method name. We'll see what our merged arguments are. Merged arguments. So the merged arguments are working there. That is what I would expect. And then it's not calling the method. So define method. our sides. Got our number of dice. Try the underscore there and see if that does anything. Okay, we're still of dice. Oh, you know what? This might not work consistently when we try to define it. Let me think about this. All right, so I'm going to see if I have access to bonus when I'm defining this method. So I do have that in defined method. So that is where we want to do our actual see if we're still broken here. On all right. So what we need to do in this case when we're defining this method is explicitly set the bonus there. We'll make check bonus integrity a bang method. In the method itself. Right. So that is how we're doing it in the other versions. We're going to check the bonus integrity, and then we'll explicitly do methods argument bonus is the bonus. And we're still failing here. Merged args is our problem. Back to convenience methods. Merged args does not exist anymore. Down to three failures. That is encouraging. Roll 6d100, so that is probably an error in my spec. Yep. So that should get us down to two failures. Does. And what is our remaining failure here? So we've got line 42. All right, so that is another failure of me. Alright, so that should get us down to still two failures. We are missing the bonus there. Which line? Yeah, that's correct. It'll only be calling, will not be calling method missing with merged options. It'll be calling it with method options. So that solves that, I hope. Down to one failure. And now we just need to update our pattern. So our pattern now becomes similar to what we had before. And did that fix things? It did. Passing on everything. This is encouraging. We will take a look at our code coverage. Code coverage is looking good. RuboCop, what is our, all right, avoid comma after last item in a hash. Yeah, those are all let those autocorrect. And we're we're down to two. So useless assignment to match data in. Yep, don't need that. Just returning it. Down to one, which is our method length. Sure, we're still passing, we are. So method length, we've got too much going on here. Well, for one, we can get rid of the puts. That will knock us down to exactly what we need, I think. No results. Make sure we don't have any results of puts there. Didn't break anything. RuboCop is no longer angry. Pretty much give me what I want. So we will add that. We will commit it. Pause, write my commit message. So we've got our commit message here. We'll save it, sign it, and we will attempt to push this. Our backlog item. And it has all four of these, so we'll just leave that backlog item in progress, and we'll make separate commits for each of these four items. Now that we've done the yeoman's work of muddling through getting the first version of this to work, getting the other three to work should not be that difficult. So we'll check on our GitHub action. It's green, and we'll see you in the next video. Thanks for watching this stateless Codecast. Be sure to like, comment, subscribe, and spread the word. You can follow us on social media at Stateless Code. Until next time, keep coding, and don't aggress against peaceful people or vote for others to do so on your behalf.